Sudan's warring generals agreed to a new 72-hour truce to take place from Sunday, US and Saudi mediators said after fighting intensified with deadly airstrikes in Khartoum and an exodus of wounded from Darfur over the border into Chad. The airstrikes had killed 17, including 5 children. The nationwide truce goes into effect at 6 a.m. and will last until June 21, according to a joint statement. The Kingdom of Saudi Arabia and the United States of America announced the agreement of representatives of the Sudanese Armed Forces and the Rapid Support Forces on a ceasefire throughout Sudan for a period of 72 hours, the statement read. The statement also said that both the military and the RSF agreed to stop fighting and refrain from seeking military advantage during the ceasefire, and also would allow the unimpeded movement and delivery of humanitarian assistance throughout the country. Fighting between the Sudanese army and the paramilitary rapid support forces is entering its third month, with neither side gaining a clear advantage. The army has the advantage of air power in Khartoum and its neighbouring sites, Omdurman and Bahri, while the RSF has embedded itself in residential neighbourhoods. On Friday and Saturday, the army appeared to ramp up strikes, hitting several residential neighbourhoods. In a speech posted by the army on Friday, Top General Yasser Al-Atta warned people to stay away from homes the RSF had occupied. Late on Friday, the local resistance committee said that 13 people had been killed by shelling in Al-Lamab in western Khartoum, calling the neighborhood an operations zone. Residents reported airstrikes elsewhere in southern and western Khartoum into the afternoon. The strikes was the latest in a series of air and artillery attacks on the poor and densely populated districts of the city, where most residents are unable to afford the cost of living. A record 25 million people, more than half the population, are in need of aid and protection, according to the United Nations, which said it has received only a fraction of the necessary funding. The conflict in Sudan broke out in mid-April, capping months of increasing tensions between Abdel Fattah al-Burhan and his former deputy Mohamed Hamdan Daglo, the representative leader of the military and the RSF, after the two fell out in a power struggle. The conflict has plunged the country into chaos and turned Khartoum and other urban areas into battlefields. The paramilitary forces occupied people's houses and other civilian properties since the onset of the fighting, according to residents and activists. The clashes have killed hundreds of civilians and wounded thousands of others. More than 2.2 million people have fled their homes to safer areas inside Sudan or crossed into neighboring countries.
Subscribe to One India channel and never miss an update.